Abari. My name is Stephen Mutua Ithanzu. I am the farm manager at Kamiti Medium Security Prison in Nairobi, Kenya, and this is my story. I studied in Australia in the University of New England, and I undertook a two-year Master of Science Agriculture degree. What I studied has impacted positively in the work which I'm doing here as the farm manager in Kamiti, where I'm able to train inmates on how to do farming and produce their food. The reason why I love agriculture is that I believe if you are competent in food production, you cannot sleep with an empty stomach. And this has been a problem in most of our countries, African countries. The only way to make our people get enough food is educating them and allowing them to gain more knowledge in agriculture. Kamiti Medium Security Prison Farm operates under a revolving fund. We get money which we use to produce food like maize, beans, and vegetables. Once we prepared everything, we have harvested everything, we weigh, measure, and package. We take what is enough for our prison and we sell the rest to the other prisons. Without sustainability, we cannot be able to achieve our goals in food security. Because we have labor, we have water, and we have land, Kamiti is secure in food production for a long time. When I studied in Australia, we used to do practical lessons, and this enabled us to go and visit other farms, where I was able to see the way farmers do their work and the farm layout, and that has also contributed into the way I'm doing my work here in Kamiti. I learned about demonstration plots, where you can bring a bunch of inmates, they see what you are doing, it's a small area, they can learn very fast, then from there, once they establish their interest, you can transfer them to the bigger fields where they can go and work. That I learned in Australia. Again, I also learned about agricultural extension, how best to transfer the knowledge to the farmer. So I'm using that extension skills to transfer my knowledge to the inmates and even my staff who I'm working together, and they are really appreciating that, and I can see success in it.
Since the day he started, Stephen has made a big difference to the farm and to the prisoners. He has been a big encouragement to me, encouraging me that if I work hard, I can make a big contribution to my country, Kenya.
There is an African saying that a man who does not travel thinks that his mother is the best cook. So if you study locally, you think that you are getting the best education. But let me tell you that when I went to Australia, I was able to meet the best brains in the field of agriculture. And I was keen to get the best knowledge from them. I sat under the best lecturers I've ever met in Australia, and I would say whoever goes out there will gain that first-class education. I feel that I should share the knowledge I gained in Australia with many people. If I limit myself within my farm and my family, I will just go and pass with my knowledge. But I've received an opportunity whereby I'm interacting with so many people within the prison fraternity. There are farmers who come here to consult on how to grow their fruits. I feel good when I'm advising them. We have the prisoners whom I'm training about agricultural activities. I feel good about it. My fellow staff are also coming to consult with me. I also feel good about it. But I've also not forgotten myself. I'm also doing some little farming back at home, and my family is also enjoying the knowledge which I have. One time, one inmate came and told me it is like a blessing in disguise to be in Kamiti Medium Security Prison, because when he was outside, he had no skills. He only knew the only way to get something for himself is to go and steal. But when he was arrested and brought here, we started training them about maize and beans production, fruit tree production, and livestock. He said that he feels that he's more blessed. In 10 years to come, I would like to see Kamiti Medium Security Prison and Kenya as a whole being able to produce enough food for its people and even produce surplus which Kenya can export. The most rewarding part of my work and what makes me happy is when I see that we have trained an inmate, he has finished his sentence, and he goes out and gets a job. When I meet him in the streets or I learn where he is and I'm able to go and see what he's doing, I feel contented in my heart, realizing that I have not failed, but I have achieved something.